press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello guys, I'm Manish. Hopefully you have been with me in my other videos. So what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna start a new series of videos which will take our Arduino projects to next level. Till now what we have done with Arduino is that serial monitor pops up on the screen and we can get some text and send some text back to the Arduino. But if we could somehow pull out data from Arduino to a computer, we could process it in different manner using different libraries we have in our programs. So the possibilities are pretty much endless. So in this video, we will be using Python to process raw data from the Arduino and would do some really cool stuff with that. So without any further ado, let's get started. Type in Python 2.7. Remember, we need 2.7. We won't be using 3 in this tutorial. Okay. Hopefully this one should work. Yeah, this is official. Download 32-bit installer. So after you have installed it, what you have to download next is PySerial. Download 32-bit. Install it in default directory. So after you have installed PySerial, now we are all set to install our last software required for this course. So type in VPython 2.7. Go to first link. Here it says we have to install 32-bit Python 2.7.9, which we have already done. Click on this second link, VPython Win32py 2.7. It's gonna redirect you to source code page. Wait for seconds. Okay guys, now we're ready to use our Python. So let's first upload this Arduino code. If you don't understand, don't worry, we'll be having rigorous discussion on this in upcoming videos. Let's start VIDLE. Okay, now we have to import the serial library which we downloaded. After that, we need to import this visual library, that is VPython 2.7, which we downloaded. Okay. Now we can create the object. Okay, I will be creating cylindrical object of length 4, radius 0.5 and color red. For the syntax, just follow along with me. We will be having much better discussion in upcoming videos. Okay, since the Arduino is sending data at very fast rate, we need our Python to keep listening to that serial port. Okay, I forgot to make a serial object. Let's do that now. Data equals serial dot serial. And under argument, we need two arguments. One, the first one is the COM port, and the second one is the baud rate. In my case, the COM port is 3. Now in this if we have to write data.inWaiting. It makes sure that actually the Arduino is sending you data and is not busy doing something else. Okay. Okay, if Arduino is sending data, now we can write what we have to do under this indented block. Now I'll be reading data from Arduino and storing it in variable k. Okay, when we use read line in Python, the data type is all automatically string. So we need to convert it to float or int so that we can do some calculation with it. Let me do that now. I created new variable y and it will be of float type. Okay. Let's print this data. I missed one bracket here. Okay, my program is running now, but I can't see any cylinder or something in this. Okay, as you can see, my Python is able to fetch data from the Arduino, but making it draw something, we'll have to. Let's create an object and dynamically change the parameters of the object, which can be done by the object dot the parameter which you need to change. In my case, it is length. Now I can see the visual dialog has crashed. But the Arduino is still sending the serial data. That can be fixed by the rate function. So basically what we are doing here is we are asking Python to run this loop only 20 times a second. Doing that, we can fix the crashing issue of our visual library. Now we are done. Yeah, fine. As you can see, my Python is plotting the cylinder as per the data received from the Arduino. Okay guys, goodbye. See you in next video.